My name is Morten Scheibye Knudsen. I am a research fellow here in Baltimore at the National Institute on Aging, where I sort of try to figure out why we grow old. We know that as we get older, some of us are going to develop various diseases in the brain that leads to Alzheimer's disease or Parkinson's disease, diseases that are very prevalent in the society and has a huge impact on healthcare. I think it's a very important field that we try to work on. I grew up in Denmark. I'm from Copenhagen. I think I always knew it, that I wanted to be a scientist. I wasn't quite sure what type of scientist I wanted to be. I got my MD from Copenhagen. And then I moved to Greenland for a little while and worked as a physician before I got to Baltimore. And here I am. You know, people have been wondering, why do we age? Why do we grow old for thousands of years? If we're interested in curing cancer, curing dementia, curing cardiovascular disease, we really need to understand why are we getting these diseases. And aging is the number one risk factor for all of these diseases. I mean, this is sort of very controversial. And there are many theories about why the brain ages. Specifically, we've been looking at some diseases where you see accelerated aging, so children that grow old very rapidly. We have some evidence as to what is driving this mechanism, this accelerated aging. And the idea is that then this may be also what is driving normal aging. We do some computer work where we've made various computer programs and developed a database that we can then use to go into the lab and then prove various things in the lab. So this is a network of diseases. Each dot here is a different disease. And we made this a computer program where we can see two diseases. If they share features, if there's, for example, both of them have dementia, then they're going to be connected by a line. So we can basically explore how diseases are connected to each other. We look at cells and how cells grow, how cells behave under various circumstances. So this is a laser capture dissection microscope, which means whatever microscopic cell that we want to study, we can shoot that with a laser so it pops off the plate and then it can be captured in a tube. And we can then measure various stuff with that cell. This is sort of a very specific age-related feature, and that is hearing loss. So as we grow old, we tend to lose our hearing. And so using this microscope, we can look at loss of cells in the inner ear. And we can then use that as a marker of aging, why we grow old. If we can, for example, see that we are preserving the cells in the inner ear, then that can tell us that we're doing something right with our treatments. We can also look at the structures of the brain, so look at how various parts of the brain change with age. So generally with age, your brain tends to shrink a little bit with each year that passes, unfortunately. And we can then look at whether or not changes to diets or exercise can change the way the brain shrinks, for example, with aging, whether or not we can reverse that. So I think in 20 years, I think we're going to have some understanding of possible interventions for age-associated diseases. So instead of having to, for an elderly person, having to take, you know, 10 pills a day. So imagine you can potentially take a pill that will treat all diseases, you know, because we know what is actually causing aging. And the more you think about a topic like this, the more interesting it also becomes. You can get up in the morning and have an idea, and you can convert that thought into something that can potentially change the world, basically. So you have some really an amazing opportunity. The field or science is actually growing exponentially, so it's becoming bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and you're going to focus on a relatively small area, so you really need to piece together knowledge from many people.
So I have to find Tadu. So he's coming today, right?
I think so, yeah.
And will you have time to do the seahorse counting?
I'll do them very soon. Mm-hmm. And then soon we'll have a fantastic result.
Yes.
You want to work hard and you have that idea and you want to pursue that idea and figure out what's really going on. Everybody has the potential to go very, very far, and there's no limit, basically, I think. You know, you only set your own limits. That's why we're here right now at this stage in civilization. That's because of people like me and whoever's watching. You can actually go out and you can change the world.